So this is looking like a pretty damn good start so far. So let's bring this down here, and it's got 12 movement. Okay, well, the good start may have gotten a bit worse here. We've already found the Yore, and we can't understand a word they're saying because we don't have the universal translator yet. Okay, so there's the surveyor ship. I don't think the AI would declare war on me at this stage, but that's not great. I'm inclined to actually bring that down to there now, rather than colonize that. Especially with the Yore down there. Yeah. So, let's bring this down here. Oh, maybe I should find out about that sun as well. Okay, so there's two planets over there. Okay, quite a lot of planets to colonize nearby then. Right. With these settings, there's more. Well, although there's less stars, it's much more likely that if you find the star, there's going to be half the world there and potentially lots of them as well. With the settings I picked. So let's keep on coming down here. What's that? Right, no, nothing there. So if that's here already. And they do get a movement bonus, movement 7 already, when mine is only 4, and I've actually got a movement point bonus from attack, which not sure they have. Yeah, so those movement bonuses even on this level are pretty significant. So the Yule were probably over here then maybe, which is actually a bit close. Closer than I would like. Right, and the Yule are very, very good at colonizing extreme worlds, so that could be an issue with the changes recently in the amount of extreme worlds that I've selected with the options. Let's come on, keep on coming down there then. Right, this colony ship then, let's well, if the Yore are over there, I should maybe be bringing it over there, but I think I've got to grab that precursor world, make sure about it. I'm definitely gonna have to be careful about influence, or maybe try and rush towards atmospheric cleansing. If you're wondering where the tech is to get that, I believe it is there. Okay, so we're getting off one of those colony ships. Something that's very easy to forget is actually to move colony ships out of your shipyard, especially if you press cancel. So I need to definitely remember that. Right, so we'll get a colony ship there, and I'll probably go and colonize those two. Yeah, with the next two colony ships. Let's end the turn after I've slightly changed my tax rate. Since we're at 100%, it got went up to 100% because I lowered the population. I could probably change this a bit. So it's a, well, as it happens, not really. Yeah, I still want to keep it on 100%. So it's a little bit of micro with that, but at some point in the game, you actually probably just want to fix tax rate. So it's only a really early game, you want to be keeping it higher. Right, sadly it's not quite 100%. Yeah, there's quite a big drop off I've noticed with influence as well with that. Because I've lost like 14% off my influence for only 3% off the tax rate. So yeah, it really affects your influence a lot having lower approval. Which, yeah, something to consider sometimes. That's very cheap, so let's rush that one. Okay. And I want to find out about that. That's not going to be able to get that. Let's come over to here. Right. I'll get that on the way. Right, this. Right, let's move one there and see what that sun holds. Nothing, sadly. Yeah, I'll come down to there and I'll sweep around there a bit. I think I want to find out where this your home world is. If I can find out where the home world is, that would give me an advantage. There's a barren world there. Now, the your are actually able to colonize barren worlds, and I'm not able to colonize barren worlds currently. So it's a barren world, and also that which I am able to colonize. I don't think that you're particularly good at influence, so I could like culture flip that if I were to get it, maybe. In theory. I haven't actually played against the Yore though yet with the new patch and Intrigue, so yeah, I'm hoping they're better influence, put it that way. Right, let's keep on coming down here then. Hopefully I can find this other planet there. I haven't yet, so I guess I'll move one over. All the planets are always within three tiles of a sun. At one point within the game, it didn't give you information about the planets on here, so yeah, you would have to loop around always to find the planets, three tiles. But yeah, I found that here, so let's come around here now, I think, and have a look to see if I can find this your capital. Right, let's bring this down to there then. Right, and that is making that, isn't it? So I'm not gonna buy that, I believe. And yeah, should I go for, you know what, I might actually change my mind with this, because yeah, there's a lot of planets nearby, and if I get this I can get the hyperdrive plus, which will increase I can, yeah, get a better drive on, so, and also the range might come in handy. So yeah, I'm actually going to change my mind and go for that in this circumstance. Okay, so I wasted a turn of research in the other direction, but it shouldn't be much of an issue. Let's end the turn. I am slowing down getting my government as well. That will have an effect. There's a certain bonus I would get with government in 10 to pick that I'm missing out on at the moment, but I think it's worthwhile going for that first. Let's press cancel for that colony ship for the time being. Yeah, I'm going to bring it out over to there, I think. Right, so let's get that space junk. So this is our first anomaly. And there's a number of these videos for certain first that you achieve. Wow, we've got a massive 1 billion credits, which sounds pretty good in real life, but maybe not in Galaxy 3. So this is the worst reward we could have got. The space junk actually is the worst type of anomaly. The maximum you can get is 100 billion credits. So they're not really all that worthwhile going out of your way to get often. But yeah, to a certain degree they are. I want to come up here, but do I have the range yet? Well, I could probably see up to there, but maybe not up to there. I might want to come down here with this, but maybe not. Maybe that would be able to see it. Okay, I'm gonna move this one first then. Let's come down and find these. So this is huge, getting this early on, and you often would be able to get it on within the bazaar quite early, but not always. More Promethean down there. There was yeah, nothing there. So we still haven't found the your home worlds. Right, let's start coming over here. And that is actually your homeworld. That's Iconia, which actually, that used to be the Iconians' homeworld as well in the lore. So they've got a lot of food which the robots don't actually need, so they should probably get rid of that. That's very close to over here, and I could definitely lose out on these, at least one. Yeah, so that wouldn't be good. And there's a high chance they're going to get that. Won't be able to do anything about it. In the meantime, let's keep on. They're really close to my starting positions. That's really pretty bad, actually. I would have hoped them to be further away. So, I could lose out on a lot of planets to them, actually. Especially since they have, two, three movement bonus, I think, something like that. So this colony ship, let's continue it down there. Maybe I should have brought it over there, actually, considering that's there. How are we looking here? Did I forget that this turn or last turn? I might have done. I have a propensity to do it. Yeah, let's get this out. Right, so which one do I want? Wow, there's three food there. My memory of what these resource types actually do isn't great, to be honest. Games really benefit from like a encyclopedia type thing, but there aren't many 4X games that have it. You can come into here though and find out a bit about these, for instance, what bonuses they give on the planet, all of these resources. So that's certainly helpful, but I can't remember how some of these are useful in other ways. I can do special things with citizens a bit later on, for instance, with many resources. So I think that's the better world. Let's go towards that. That's going to take 3-4 turns, which may be too much. I think the Yordo, Stardock actually did a development diary type journal entry on the Yor recently, which is pretty good read. I think they may have to build up their population actually before they really start colonizing, so hopefully that is the case. Shipyard is idle again. Let's get out another occupier. So that one I'll have come down to here as well. And then we'll have to see after that. I guess I'll bring that up there then. So let's go and grab this space junk and come up in this direction. We should get a range boost as well in a bit, so I can come up to there. Right, can I increase my tax rate with yeah, I can. So I'm not exactly going to be getting much more cash out of this. In fact, it's like one credit for 18%, so it's barely worthwhile moving that slider, arguably. Put on 17% just in case the population increase here affects Lins. By putting it up to 100% as well, you can see the growth per turn amount there. It's plus 2. That's really important when you're pumping out colony ships, increasing that amount. So, yeah, I can get the population back. I don't want to get in too low, frankly. Which it may well do if I'm going to be making a lot of colony ships. Let's end the turn. Okay, so I'm going to be dreading losing out on these for a while now. Keeping an eye on those. Let's come up here and grab that space junk. Bit better this time, 31 billion credits. And let's come up here. Right, let's keep on coming over here then with this. Oh, more habitable worlds. In fact, there's two down here. Yeah, we got a big race on against the Yor, and it's going to be very hard to beat them once they're starting to make their colony ships. If they're not already. So you can't actually see what they're making now. Presumably you'd have to get a spy, which was brought in Crusade. So the intrigue is more political intrigue rather than espionage, I would say. Yeah. Sponsor manufacturing is 12.5. That doesn't sound exactly great. What's mine? 11.9. It's actually better. But I'm going to be increasing mine a lot coming up, definitely. I'm sure they'll increase theirs a bit as well. Quite a bit. Right, so let's keep on coming over here then. So any more? Well, let's stuff down. Yeah, there's going to be a massive race on to beat them to worlds coming up. Right, let's come up here to find that next, I think. Now I'll come back down. Are there any... No asteroids within my territory yet. If there were, I would buy them. Okay, so let's end the turn. Oh, can I buy anything? Oh, yeah, I probably should buy that because it's right on the verge. It's pretty cheap. Okay. Right, next turn. Right, so hopefully they're making scouts or something rather than colony ships at this stage, but I don't know. Right, there's a capsule there, which we haven't picked up yet. One of those. Let's go and grab that. Hopefully it's a bit of a tech boost. Experience points, that's pretty useless for the ship. Don't intend to use it in combat. I think experience points just give extra hit points. Right, let's... Oh, they built a constructor probably recently, which is better than the colony ship. For my purposes, anyway. Let's come up here. Oh, they've actually colonized there already. And there's another world there. This is the Marmabati system. So, looks like all of those are colonizable for us. Holy crap, there is a class 20 world there, and it's a precursor world. So they probably should have colonized that one rather than when they did. Should I just go straight to that then? I'm definitely inclined to do so. Okay. This is a pretty unusual start so far, that I'm used to anyway. Right, so I'm gonna come back down here now, I think. With this. Oh, actually, there was. I'd better find a position of where it was with this. Right, there it is. Okay. Nice big, huge purple world. And what was it again? Oh, it's bonus to production. Yeah, it's a very, very good world. So there's gonna be. I think there's 5 of those precursor planets on this map with the settings I use. The small mod I made, one for each race, yeah, and we've got 2 nearby, so that's pretty lucky. Let's come down here now then. Right, research, oh I completed that already, did I? Interstellar travel, so I can now get better engines, and I got more range, and there's better sensors, and loads of other things. There's a wonder associated with this, that one locates homeworld of all hyperdrive capable civilizations. I would need Promethion to be able to make it though. Right, let's come back now. Well, I could potentially go for yet more movement speed. Out of these, I probably preferred that one. This has, yeah, long term. Well, that one's very good. Very good. But you probably get about plus 1 movement by taking this. It makes things like the colony module and also the constructor module less mass, so you can fit on more engines in effect. So probably preferred that one. 11 turns. I guess I'm going to have to pick that up first. I think I will, because I can then get extra research via that, which might, yeah, get that more quickly, arguably. A bit quicker anyway. Right, so I think we're done for the turn. I haven't forgotten the colony ship there. Get one out, another one out next turn. So let's end turn. Oh, tax rate actually. But I might not forget that, because otherwise the growth rate's going to be worse. 0.1 instead of 0.2. And I actually reached this precursor world. This is Grimdor 3, so let's colonize that, and things are about to really kick up a notch by colonizing this. Okay, so first colony video there. Study the Promethion Refinery. Right. So we got 3 options. Better read this, it's pretty interesting actually. So, study the Promethion Refinery. 2 giant precursor structures orbit the poles of this world. They seem to have been used to somehow terraform a Promethion gas giant into a habitable world. We are able to use the Promethion stored in them to increase the range of any ships built by our shipyard. Our scientists think they can do more with these giant machines. I would like your permission to study them further. So I definitely want to go malevolent with the Drengin, and yeah, I've really got to pick this pick. It's plus 8 to colonies morale. That's freaking amazing anyway, especially with the recent pop changes and morale changes. So I'm going to want a lot of population on this world, I think. I'll be making a lot of cities later on, which increase the population. Yeah, so let's go for that. And that should unlock my first ideology pick as well. So there's some food down here, but I think there was a negative to it. So I may even scrap that, but probably not. There's ability to make another shipyard. But what I could do is have the production from this world go back to Drenji. I just saw a colony ship there. So this is a key thing that happens with colonizing your first world. And I did delay it a little bit to make sure I got that. I can now get a new government. So let's open the government screen. And this is the new Galactic News Network, which is also giving us an update on the galaxy. Yeah, we only know the Yaw yet at the moment. And it's another event. So this is the cult. New cult has begun to spread on Drenji. The cult has grown wealthy by convincing rich members to make substantial donations. The followers believe that we were given life by an alien species, and they predict that these creators will soon return to lead us. Going malevolent again here. It's extra morale on Drenji, which is pretty damn good. So, great. Right, I'm going to press cancel for the time being on that. And here we get to see the government screen. So each and every one of these governments does something different. They have a variety of bonuses. We can see this first one here, Colonial Government. It mentions, gives a description here. We have brought peace and enlightenment to our planet. It is our responsibility to bring it to the world beyond. So if I were to select this government, I would get a 10% boost to social construction. Our growth rate would be increased. Our colony limit would be 4. It mentions the number of colonies this government can support before global approval starts being penalized. So, yeah. If you have too many colonies, your approval really tanks. You've got to be very careful with that. This one's a democracy by the looks of it, so elections are held. If you lose an election, that can have consequences. And, also, there's a contracts ability here. You can send missions, which is ability from a shipyard. Not all of these have that, I believe. The other governments, well, the top row here are like the early governments, and the only other government I can actually choose from here happens to be the Imperial government currently. The theocracy is unique. Well, you can see there in the details, the red at the bottom, it mentions bureaucrats' racial trait required. Now, I believe that is a racial trait the Kryn happen to have. This one, unity, gives extra influence. It's its main bonus. That you need the ancient racial trait, that's the Altarians, which we'll be seeing later on. Later on, if I happen to have the diplomacy tech, I could get the Interstellar Republic. And that one actually has a number of bonuses and even restrictions as well. The cryptocurrency mentioned there, that's the Galactic Market, another key feature within the Intrigue. It's from the Bazaar, basically. And I believe you don't need mercenaries to get that working. It just, if you have Intrigue, it unlocks. But I doubt the ship's part does. You probably would need the mercenaries expansion for that. So I could go that later on. But for now, I'm going to be going Imperial. This is a strict hierarchy. It mentions, our history is littered with once great empires who stopped conquering and fell to ruin. We will not be one of them. Now, there is a negative to diplomacy here, which certainly isn't great. That could get us involved in wars earlier. We get a bonus movement point, though, which is crucial, very important within the colony phase, if you've got a lot of colonies to go after, which we do. There's also a ship construction bonus, also very important bonus if you want to get ships out quicker. So this is really why you arguably most times you want to get that planet in your starting system colonized for most races early to get those bonuses. If you're going down this route, I mean, you could of course go down Colonial or one of these others, but I think Imperial is rather good. There are no elections, so there's no downsides for now. I'm trying to remember what the downsides are, actually. There is actually a journal entry on it. I'll stick an annotation here mentioning about it. There is a colony limit, of course, there as well. Later on, there's much more governments when you unlock other things. With that one, no, you need to be benevolent to actually get it. So, yeah, some of these have some pretty nice bonuses. There are even extra ships for a lot of these as well. And, yeah, all different types of features. Later on, you can see there the amount of planets you can colonize increases a lot. That's a colony limit of 24. This one, I think, doesn't have. Well, you can. There's no colony. Oh no, there is a colony limit on that one. One of the. Oh. No, it's not that one. Which one is it? I think it's this. Yeah, Galactic, no colony limit. So you could have infinite colonies with this one. Which was the case before in the game, but is no longer with the new governments. What has come in now is Commonwealths. A subservient empire to yourself, basically, Commonwealth is. And I believe you get money. From them, which you can do if you go beyond that amount and don't want to tank your approval. Let's pick a Imperial though. I can talk much more about this government and all their features later on and will be. There is a downside to picking a government. That is the fact that you're not able to change out of it for 26 weeks. Yeah, so that could be an issue, but I'm definitely going to change to that. I'm more than likely going to want to get one of these governments that increases the colony limit to at least 12 later on, because I'm going to want to colonize a lot. So, 26 weeks could be a long time actually, especially since there's a lot of planets over here. Hopefully that one will. Wow, it's looking to move on that already. There's a huge advantage the AI has, and yeah, it'd be like 20 odd movement on the hardest difficulty levels, so I wouldn't stand a chance now colonizing the AI on that difficulty. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to try my best though to grab these worlds. The colony ship was finished there, and I believe I need to stick a new one in. Now I've actually got pre-made ships in here, so I'm gonna make that next, I think. I have a naming convention for my ships as well, so what that means is two drives, one range, and that's Mark 2, so that means the second level of modules on those. If we have a look at this ship, that has two hyperdrive pluses and environmental support, which is all of the second level ones. Yeah. From a recent tech I picked up, and I've run out of space that I can't fit anything more on. Okay, so it's D2, R1, M2 I want to be making now. Let's just come into here. 4-turn Sally, which is a bit much, frankly. We picked up an ideology pick as well. With ideology, I would say the motivation line is still by far the most powerful line. This just gives a ton of extra production. It has been nerfed a bit at various points within Galaxy 3's since Galaxy 3's release. But yeah, production's so important early game and throughout the game, frankly. This one is amazing. This one, it mentions doubles the military production of a homeworld. I think that's actually an error now. It's been changed. It's actually the bottom bit, 10%, which is nowhere near as good, frankly. Yeah, so this is great, and because it's so good, I wouldn't pick anything else really, or at least primarily go for a certain group. The benevolent ideology picks, well, there's a lot. Well, there's a couple of extra colony ships in here, free planet there. There's a lot of extra approval bonuses, I think, and research down here. But it's nowhere near as good as the production, frankly. Pragmatic does have some nice picks, and I may be dipping into this a bit later on. There's actually been a change where, yeah, it's more expensive to make picks from other ideologies now. For instance, if I were to pick this, basically the next cost goes up 10 points, and that's the case for all ideologies now. It used to only go up like half that amount. So it's harder to diversify between them than it once was. But there's a lot of good picks here. The free Yeah, I didn't actually consider this then. I could have gone for the three constructor vessels and maybe turned them into colony ships and colonized a lot with them. I haven't done that for a while, but it may have been a good opportunity to do it here. But it would have made Malevolent a lot more expensive, and getting into that soon is very important. It's maybe why I shouldn't have picked one of the events for that 5 points. And took the diplomacy hit instead. At some point, I'm probably going to want to get that though. That will prevent anyone from declaring war on me for 50 turns, especially with the yaw nearby. I think that could be pretty crucial. So I probably will want to get that eventually. Okay, so that's ideology. We've got our government. Let's take a look at this in a bit more detail as well. So you can see these are your ministers, basically. And we can, yeah, these are the bonuses that we saw earlier. And later on, there are crises, which you can actually get a crises manager. I think it's, yeah, it mentions after you've actually successfully completed the crisis. Commonwealths are here. I'm not going to be able to show you this though until we have more colonies than we're allowed. Yeah, so I can show that off a bit later on. Okay, so next. Oh, this is the world we just recently colonized. Now I can add the production from that world up to here. How much would it be? 5.9 production, I think. That's actually pretty significant. So I am actually going to do that. But I do want to make a shipyard here pretty soon. But I can't now because if you relay your production, it prevents you from doing it. So that is a downside. I would have made it otherwise. In the meantime, then, I'm going to make some production. And it's not easy to figure out where to place it here. Basically, later on, you can get extra tiles, and the tiles that are liable, where they're liable to turn up, is based on the graphic. So it's probably going to be tiles, yeah, on all of these land masses, but not in the sea. So I'm going to put. Guess I put that there, but I may be changing that later on. Okay. I think this may give a range bonus as well, I mentioned earlier on. A precursor world created by mining out a Promethean planet. Shipyard spawned by this world will have greatly increased range. So, yeah, so that shipyard, all the ships made there now will have increased range. I should get extra Promethean here as well, shouldn't I? From this world. Not sure if I'm getting it yet. Right. Let's continue moving this down here. I'm probably going to go for that. I think if I grab that, I may even be able to hopefully culture flip both of those later on. It's risky strategy doing this. Very risky. I could lose those as well by doing this, but I think I'm gonna go for it. Let's keep on coming up here then with this. There's tons going on already in this game.